Okay, how is everybody doing today? I'm doing okay, I just stupidly decided. Okay, we have an Eevee. So, we are going through Ecruteak City. Gotta love this music. So, what are we gonna try and do today? Well, I have two options, or two ideas. Thank you to my 20 followers that have stuck with me and slowly grown. I thank you all for coming to find my stream and do what you can to help support this horrible birth defect that I raise awareness for. So, let's get back to the game. So we've got our Eevee, we've got Flaffy, we've got Quilava, we've got Togepi. So, at some point we'll do a baby Pokemon run, which will include Togepi and Smoochum. I'm sorry, I'm trying to think of what all was introduced. Pichu. Magby. There's, I believe, 5 Pokemon that are considered baby Pokemon in this generation. This was actually the generation they were introduced in. So, I'm sorry, I'm just talking and not actually doing anything with this game, but that's okay. What is our main objective here? Well, there are actually Ecruteak City, the Burn Tower, and the Tin Tower. We got through Bill. Let's see. Where's the gym? So, is this the gym? Yep. This should be east. Is this the item finder? Okay, this is the item finder. So there's a handful of stuff in this game to find. Obviously the item finder, but there are a few others that I want to retrieve. We'll try and get Surf next to the pond. Now, forget the burned tower, we've got one better. So there's a pond back here. Where's the pond? Over here. Now that we have our item finder, do we need Surf? It says it's hidden. What are everyone's thoughts on this stream so far? I think our goal right now is let's go through the dance theater. This is the Kimono Girls. And then we'll deal with the dance theater. It should be here. No, this is the burn tower. This is almost as freaky as the guy. I like this gym. It's full of women. But it's not bad. Okay, I was thinking there's a way for me to get on stage. Thing is, we need to train up a little bit to actually beat Morty anyway. Let's see. I'm literally trying to figure out how to do this because we've got the Ecruteak Dance Theater. Let's start from here. This is the Ecruteak Dance Theater. We're pretty much doing Ecruteak City today. We'll deal with the gym. Now call. Okay, this should be a Flareon. Fire and fire don't actually do well against each other, but we'll make it work. Since these are all level 17, I'm kind of over-leveled. But sand attack. Now there's a funny thing. If I recall, oh, it does work. They weren't introduced until Gen 3. In Gen 3, that will not work because Flareon has Flash Fire. I forget Gen 2 doesn't have abilities yet. Lava is level 21. Yes. I have yet to use Smokescreen. Now, this should be an Espeon, which is interesting, because there's actually not a Pokemon in this area that you can use to actually fight an Espeon, except for this. So Zubat with Gen 2 can actually defeat an Espeon. But it's very weird how it works. Remember, there's no dark types other than Umbreon until we get to Kanto. Yep, that's Sile. I thought so. Send out an Espeon. Now, the only thing I have to worry about is Psychic. Or Confusion. I forgot it knew Confusion. Oh, please don't faint. And that is why you worry about things like this. Because now, we're just going to use Thundershock. But it fails. I cannot believe it one-shotted my Zubat. We're just gonna tackle. And Espeon slowed down. Now this is Sile, which would have been Sakura. For those trying to figure out who they are. I was hoping to do these all. We're gonna probably take on the gym next, but we need to go through the burn tower and everything before we can go through enough. Wrong area. Back in the dance theater. Okay, that should have been Espeon. Now, this is where Zubat is going to come into play. Because this... should be an Umbreon. Yep. One Umbreon. Umbreon sprite is actually cute. Umbreon used Tail Whip. It is super effective against Umbreon, but Umbreon has such high defense. People forget Umbreon has basically the highest defense of any dark type. I mean, even if Umbreon weren't, even if the levels were basically the same, now I can't withdraw. Please get a crit. It's gonna tail whip itself into oblivion. No, that's fine. I was afraid of that. That gives you an idea of just how defensive Umbreon really is. Umbreon is basically the highest defense dark type in the game. So that was the Umbreon. This should be a Vaporeon. Yep, I put Flaffy in front. Perfect. That should be an automatic KO. Then again, I also forget. This is part of why I want to do an Eevee run. Because I want people to understand just how powerful some of these Eevee evolutions really were. I mean, they were defensive beasts. Thank you. This should be a Jolteon. Yep. Was Thundershock? Okay, I was trying to figure out, was Thundershock classified as a physical move? I know there was a physical special split, but it wasn't until like three generations from now. Or two generations from now. Basically the beginning of Gen 4 was when the physical special split happened. And now we have Surf. What day is today? Okay, it's Thursday. Let's go into the Burn Tower. Funny enough, I should say he starts out with Haunter. Oh, I should have healed. Haunter. Yes. Because we can now use Flaffy against Croconaw. And that gets rid of the curse. I The only thing we're not probably not gonna do is get through Morty's gym. Let's flip back to Quilava. Quilava should knock out Magnemite with one hit. Since Magnemite is a steel type. Oh, wow. Not gonna do much, but I should say it's gonna faint Magnemite. That's all I really wanted it to do. Unless it crits, it's good. And there goes Flaffy. Or there goes Zubat. Yeah, Flaffy's on my side. Okay, let's do two things. Is this the gym? There's one last thing we need to do before we enter the gym, and that is dealing with setting the beasts free. Now, the interesting thing is, all three of the beasts know Roar, which is why they are actually so hard to catch. Helen. Okay. So let's go back into the tower. Set the three Pokemon free, and then we'll deal with Morty next week. I kind of planned... coughing. Okay, I guess we're not. Probably not going to use much of Flaffy, so. And Tackle is gone. Okay. Where is that rock that I'm supposed to break? Oh, I've got to go back up. Because it was that rock that I was supposed to break above. Use Rock Smash on. Okay. Come on. Work with me. Fire Breather. Send out Charmeleon. Goes Charmeleon. Level 23. We are almost there. Folks, please bear with me. I know this has taken a while, but max speed. That really didn't help much, but this should put me in the center of the room. Yep. Entei, Raikou. There goes Suicune. Now we don't want to go off yet. Yeah, we do. Because there's another hole we can drop into. Or was. There's nothing else we can do in this place until we get the rainbow wing. So, next week we are going into the gym in Ecruteak City to take on Morty. Take on the ghost trainer. There are only two things I want to do, and I believe this is it. So I will see you next week. I stream for an organization called CDH Stars and Angels. We're a 501c3 nonprofit that helps children with congenital diaphragmatic hernia. If you could, please go check out our website at cdhstarsandangels.org or our Facebook page at cdhstarsandangels. But for the CDH Warrior, I'm Drew Monday, and I will see you next week with, well, next time, with another episode of The Legend of Zelda Minish Cap. But we will be trying to work on getting Togepi leveled up to where we can get Togetic. We're not going to level, we're just going to hope the friendship raises up, and we're going to try and get Zubat to Crobat. So, for the CDH Warrior, I'm Drew Monday, and I will see you on Monday. Have a great day.